Last week, a group of opposition legislators led by the leader of opposition in parliament, Mathias Mpuuga, accused security agencies of abducting and torturing 80-year-old Constantine Muhonja, a resident of Kasese. According to Enanga, Muhonja was implicated by the four suspects who were arrested in connection to the Busika police attack. Enanga further points out that Muhonja sneaked people to the DRC, where they were recruited into the rebel ADF group.
We interrogated them and they indicated that when they were being transported from Uganda to the DRC, they had a conduit in Kasese whom they identified as Constantine Muhonja, the 80-year-old suspect, who always facilitated the movement of recruits from Uganda to the DRC and also received the ADF operatives who had completed training.
On the claims that the elderly Muhonja was tortured to death, Enanga clarifies that the deceased, while in detention at Chireka, slid in a bathroom and sustained head injuries which caused his death, not torture as alleged.
These are wild allegations that are not true. Although Honorable Mathias Mpuuga suspected foul play, we are happy to inform him, the bereaved family and the public, that an inquest was conducted by a coroner who exonerated the police after the death of 80-year-old Muhonja Constantine was established to be accidental.
Relatedly, the police are continuing with countrywide operations aimed at eliminating ADF elements from the country. The latest operation was in Buteleja district, where 9 suspected ADF rebels were arrested and over 50 recruits rescued.
We managed to raid this space, which was acting as a domain for recruitment. It was also a collection center for children who are introduced to ideological messages and beliefs. And arrangements are now in place to reintegrate and reunite them with their parents, guardians and relatives. We want to ensure that we reach each and every parent out of the 59 who were actually rescued, because we believe some of them are could be recruiting agents as well. And like, for instance, there was a 15-year-old victim. Her parents didn't tell her where they were taking her, and they drove her all the way from, they transported her all the way from Barara up to that place in Buteleja, and they dumped her there.
Meanwhile, police have also cautioned parents to be vigilant as acts of fraud and fake scholarship offers are on the rise. This follows the arrest of a one Sabil Siraje, who had defrauded hundreds of parents in West Nile with millions of shillings, promising to help their children secure bursaries and scholarships from good schools in Kampala.
Sabir Siraji and his wife Geria Salma allegedly mobilized and registered over 40 children from West Nile region, and they were registering each of the 40 children at 20,000 shillings. After that, they would engage the parents and convince them that they had obtained scholarships from Al Rahman Primary and Secondary Schools located in Bombo, where they were charging or soliciting money from each of the parents.
From the Kampala Metropolitan, police in Chitezi, Wakiso district are hunting for criminals behind the kidnap and murder of a 10-year-old pupil. Luke Owais Jire, the KMP deputy spokesperson, says the deceased went missing from her parents' home last week, but her body was recovered yesterday in a cassava garden.
Yesterday, on the 6th, at about 1 PM, we received information that there was a dead body of a person that had been recovered and dumped in a cassava plantation by an unknown person. We arrived at the scene and observed that this body was of the juvenile that went missing on the 4th.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.